Oh, you're live. Nice. Oh, wow, there's actually already people in here.
Wow.
I guess it shows when I'm about to go live, but not necessarily when I do go live. Can you guys hear me and see me? Hey, what's up, everybody? Starting? Oh, can you guys hear me? Derek Miles, Jag, welcome to the stream, everybody. Nero, hey, Spencer. Thank you guys all for joining. if you guys can hear something in the background, it's a special person that is cooking up some breakfast right now. You guys will get to meet him in a moment. hey, thank you guys all for joining the stream. Thank you guys very, very much. I'm in a different setting. As you guys can see the background, I got some Tekken and some Ruby back here. Oh my god, Chibi, there's 140 people in here already.
Hello!
Wow. Hello, everybody. Thank you guys all for joining. I thought he was in the... Someone said the noise, it sounded like I was in the shower. Hello, everybody. Thank you guys for joining. Yeah, a lot of people. Wow. I cannot believe it. I'm kind of getting nervous now.
Hey, do what you do best. Just go with it.
Hello, everybody. What's cooking? Chibi, what are you cooking over there? Bacon?
Bacon, sausage, toast, bagels.
Yep, all that good stuff. He's basically making... Oh, so someone upstairs is making bacon pancakes. Like, making pancakes, making bacon pancakes. But before anything else, I do want to say that the title of the video is not misleading in any sense. Clearly, from a realistic sense, obviously that's not the case. It's more from a spiritual type of way, you know, based on the amazing time that I had this past weekend. I've had probably one of the best weekends of my entire life, aside from something like RTX. And let me move my finger out of the camera so you guys can see a bit better. Will I share the food with you? Oh my god, are you making pancakes? Because people are saying like, you're like, yeah, they're making pancakes. Okay, so some people are making pancakes upstairs and then we have bacon being made downstairs. I'm downstairs right now. I'm in the basement area. But I really wanted to make this. It's going to be like probably a really short stream, probably like 20, 30 minutes or so, just so a lot of other people can check it out and, you know, be a part of it. But I had one of the best experiences of my life this past weekend of meeting people and talking to people that I have met through the Ruby community, through the Ruby Tug screenings where we initially all met. There is about 20 people here right now that I got to meet and hang out with again after everything that had happened in the last year with Ruby Volume 1, Volume 2, Volume 3. there's people that are saying like they can hear the bacon, it's sizzling. But yeah, so to kind of kick it off and everything, I'm not going to do like a Q&A or something like that. I literally just wanted to give you guys a snippet of this experience to kind of reflect and share this moment with all of you guys, because I know Ruby and Rooster Teeth and Monty and the community means a lot to everyone, not just me. And I know how fortunate I am to be in this position of being able to meet certain people and do certain things with the community. And I always want to be able to bring you guys along for the ride, you know, whether it's a video that I'm doing at home, whether it's a vlog that I do at RTX, or whether it's a community event like this. I can honestly say this was one of the best moments of my life that I really got to have and experience, and it wouldn't have been possible, honestly, it would not have been possible without Monty. You know, I say this all the time, it comes back to his vision, it comes back to his creativity, it comes back to what his passion was, what he loved doing every single day, and, you know, making that passion into a dream and making that dream into a reality and sharing that with all of us. You know, I've expressed that in my videos, I've expressed that in my reviews, my reactions, And it's something that I never thought would get this big, where people actually cared about what I, you know, what I did, and cared about, you know, my opinions, and cared about how much I cared about what we all care about, which is, you know, the Rooster Teeth community, the Ruby community, and the fact that Monty left something amazing behind for all of us. And I just wanted to share. I wanted to share that with you guys. For those of you who are wondering where I am right now. I am currently about 45 minutes away from where I currently live. I'm in Providence, Rhode Island. We set up a Ruby community event for the weekend where a bunch of people that I met at the Ruby Tug screening, we all decided to get together after Ruby Volume 4 finished to come together to watch it as a kind of a weekend sleepover. And we are currently housed by one of Monty's brothers, Chivi Ohm, one of the big bros. And he's been incredibly hospitable in, you know, doing as much as he can to express how grateful he is that people love the work that his little brother did. And I can honestly say he's a good friend of mine. He's a great friend of mine that I'm glad that I was able and fortunate enough to be able to meet, because I never, you know, got to meet Monty. I never got to thank Monty. And, you know, Chivi and Neith are the closest thing I have to him, you know, to be able to say, I know, you know, I know Monty in essence. I know Monty through them, you know? So, Chivi, come over here. I want you guys to meet Monty's brother, Chivi Ohm.
Hey guys.
Say hi.
Hey, thanks for joining us. I wish you all could be here. You know, this is so much fun, you know?
Yeah, this is, totally. I initially met him at the Volume 1 Tug screening. And this is one of my, this isn't the voice of Ren. This is one of Monty's brothers who isn't affiliated with the show, but you want to say there's 290 people in here.
Hey, I love you guys. Oh, I love you guys. Totally family to me, you know? I mean, if you guys ever play Halo 5, I'm on all like every night. But I gotta go cook.
Yeah, so he's cooking right now. But there's currently 19 other Ruby fans, Rooster Teeth fans, that are upstairs right now that I want to invite into this mix. I'm actually gonna give a tour of the house. This is where Monty lived. I'm literally in the house of Monty Ohm. And this is the house that he lived when he lived in Rhode Island with his brother before he went over to Rooster Teeth in Texas. And I have a very special thing for you guys. And I it was incredibly hard for me to initially get through, because, you know, I never got to meet Monty, and I never, you know, I always had this idea that no matter what I did, that no matter what I did, and no matter how much people love my videos, I would never be able to thank him for the work that he did. And I honestly got that chance. It's something that I never thought in a million years I'd ever be able to do. And I'm trying to keep my composure right now, because I had a moment yesterday where I was really like blown away by it. And so I'm going to flip the camera right now. I'm gonna show you guys a bit of the house. I'm gonna introduce you guys to all the people that are upstairs, the amazing family, the dysfunctional family. It's a party upstairs, to be, honestly. So I'm gonna flip right now. I'm gonna give you a tour of Monty and Chivi's house. Give you guys a tour of the place entirely. Give a shout out to all of my friends that are here. And
the house is a little mess right now.
Yeah. Oh, well, yeah, of course. There's 20 people, including Chivi. There's 20 people here, and the house started off pretty good. And like we're reaching the tail end of the gathering. Today's Sunday. Everyone's gonna be going home. I gotta get back on my bus trip at 5 o'clock. So I'm gonna switch the camera right now, and I'm gonna give you guys a tour of Monty's house, and I'm gonna introduce you guys to other Ruby and Rooster Teeth fans. So. And here we are. So this is the basement. This is actually a well-furnished basement. This is like the lower half of the house. This is like the table that I'm at right here. We have like a bunch of Chivi and Monty's posters that are up here. We have like the Halo-inspired posters, some of the Ruby wall scrolls, Tekken, which is a big like fighting inspiration for a lot of like the choreography and stuff that Monty did, Harry Potter, and then we also have over here Is this Game of Thrones?
Yes.
I never watched Game of Thrones, so forgive me on that. But here we have Mr. Chef Ohm over here.
I don't have the apron, guys. Don't hurt the chef.
Please do nothing to the cook.
Please do nothing to the chef, guys.
Yeah, so he's making some bacon right now. Okay. Another cool thing, let me switch. Another cool thing was that Neith Ohm was here yesterday. I got to meet the voice actor of Ren, who took over for his, you know, his brother for the show. So the voice actor of Ren, he lives in Tokyo, Japan, and I, like, that was literally a once in a lifetime opportunity to ever be able to meet not just Chibi Ohm. I met Monty's other brother, I met another older sibling, Woody Ohm, and I got to meet Neith, and he was here for something completely unrelated, but it kind of aligned perfectly with, because we didn't plan that, and he didn't know that we would have 20 plus people coming over this weekend, so,
I didn't even know he was.
Yeah, Chibi didn't even know either, so.
It was last, I was like, what?
Yeah, so it was very last minute, but essentially, Neith was here yesterday. Another one of their siblings, Woody Ohm, was here yesterday as well. So we basically had the three brothers and all of the fans that were here for the weekend, and everyone essentially got to pictures, say hi, thank almost him for everything. Yeah, almost everyone, because some people had work, so some people had to get here a bit later. it's overwhelming. It really is, and I was just grateful that, you know, they weren't overwhelmed by it, and if anything, that was very welcoming for them to be like, you know, we are very proud of Monty. We're proud of our, you know, little brother for everything that he's done, for everything that, for all of the, you know, the love and the inspiration and, you know, just care that people give to the show and to each other, essentially. Like, these 17 other people, 18 other people that are upstairs, I never would have met them if it wasn't for Monty. You know, I never would have met any of these people. And I'm just thankful that Rooster Teeth has decided to continue his work to the best of their ability. And I honestly feel like he left it in great care for, like, Miles, Carrie, and Gray and all that. But I'm going to get more into it. I have something. I have a very, 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 very special occasion at the very end of the stream that I want to relay to all of you guys. But we're going to go upstairs and we're going to say hi to everybody. All right.
Hi.
All right, so we're going to be going upstairs. I'm going to give you guys a tour of the rest of the house. Mind you, it's really, really messy. So in here, this is where I slept. I slept literally right here. This is like the front of the house, and it's where you first come in. We have all of our stuff here. Like I said, there's about 20 people here, and you guys are going to meet everybody. All right, guys. We have 450 people watching right now.
Hi, guys!
Yeah, so we had a sleepover yesterday. And, oh, snap! They're watching the stream of my... I'm watching the stream of my stream of my stream of my stream right now. Mom, I'm on TV, get the camera! So, I want to go around and give everyone's first name and just say a little bit about yourself. Just brief, because we're already 15 minutes in, because I like to ramble, as you guys might know. So, I met all of these people at the Ruby Volume 1 tug screening that happened last year. This was thanks to Monty Ohm, it was thanks to Rooster Teeth, it was honestly thanks to the fact that we all have come together and love something as much as Ruby, and we all have an important person who we wish, you know, could have been here, and, you know, through his loss, we were all able to come together as a result, and for those of you who are watching, like I mentioned, someone just typed, "Now that's a katana." So, we all got really touchy yesterday, and as we always do at this point, and this is the first time I'm actually able to hang out with a lot of them, because my situation is, everyone here, like, lives in this, like, town or in this area. I live in a completely different state, so I actually went out of my way to be here with all of you guys, because I haven't seen you since October, essentially, and I literally finished telling them to, but you guys have honestly
given me one of the best days of my life, like meeting all of you guys, and I wanted the people who watch my videos to be a part of that too. So, thank you guys very much. And everyone here is just going, someone said the Pikachu pill is dope. Someone said Pikachu is also a gun.
Also a gun.
So really quick, I just want to go down the list of just everyone, just give your first name, and you know, you can just say a thing or two about, you know, the experience of meeting all of us here. There's some people here that I've met at the Volume 1 screening. There's some people that I'm meeting for the first time, like Christian. He gave me a ride here, and I fucking absolutely love you for that. John and Hunter are like anime lords, and we literally had like discussions talking about anime for like 5-6 hours to the point where my legs were hurting because I was standing too long. And just meeting all of you guys, like Casey and Sammy, obviously, I met you guys initially at the first screening, and you guys kind of orchestrated and put all this together. This is literally the embodiment of Uncle Crow, like, in its purest form. So, we're going to start with you. Your first name?
Show and tell.
Sam. Hello.
John.
I'm Casey.
Aaron.
I'm John.
Chris.
Oh, Kelly.
What's up, guys?
I'm Christian.
Hunter.
Alex.
Cam.
Charles.
Lucas.
Megan.
Peter.
Also Blake.
Steve.
Yeah. Karina.
And, oh, I'm going to switch the camera. And your boy right here. So, you make your bacon pancakes?
I made bacon pancakes!
You didn't burn the house down either.
I know, I did.
Also, Chibi brought up, like, bagels and toast.
Yeah, he, like, brought up, so, like, this right here, like, we, the house is a mess, but, like I said, we have, like,
yeah, we're
literally,
whole cleaning crew right here.
Like, Chibi just, like, picked us all up off the street, to be completely honest, so.
We don't have
one. I don't know what
he did. He adopted all of us.
Yes, yeah, we're all his children now.
Yeah, he adopted all of us.
Yep.
And I definitely want to be able to do this again. Like, we're trying to plan like a picnic or something, like something else, to be able to do this again. I want to make this, like, if not a quarterly thing, like at the most, like, I honestly want to be able to do this as much as possible, instead of just an RTX once a year, you know what I mean? And I feel like if we're able to do something like this, we can just keep it going. So I'm going to give them the tour of the rest of the house. You guys can go back to your dysfunctional...
Hey.
You're dysfunctional.
So you mean watch
yeah.
The
oh,
stream.
So watch the stream as I'm watching 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 the stream.
It's like a
couple hours. Someone just typed in the chat. Don't have a home. Move in with an ohm. Yeah. Put that on a T-shirt.
Yeah. T-shirts.
Yes,
yes,
all of us.
Yes.
We're
going to
make a trip to Six Flags, and that's all of our shirts are going to say.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
All right, so I'm gonna give them the tour of the rest of the house. So thank you guys for being at this, and enjoy the rest of the stream. Crossing swords.
Let's cross the stream.
Mine's bigger.
All right. Thanks. Thank you, guys. Love you guys. Say bye.
Bye.
We got the kitchen over here, the rest of the food. Bacon pancakes, making bacon pancakes. Make some bacon and I put it in a pancake. So that is the Ruby family that I have right now. This is like one of the spare rooms that, like Chibi lives here by himself. He has 4 bedrooms and he just lives here by himself. So whenever we all come here, we kind of like fill the void. He's actually told us that we fill the void that, you know, that was there when Monty passed away. And this is another room right here. Another empty room, mainly for, like, guests or stuff like that, but, I really love you guys, and I really want you to take away, let me close the door, because everyone's kind of socializing, but, I really want you guys to know that this goes beyond me as a YouTuber, this goes beyond me as a content creator, as a massive person in the Ruby community that is known by a lot of people. I know how fortunate I am. I know how fortunate I am to be in predicaments or situations where, you know, Barbara knows who I am, and Miles knows who I am, and the Ruby animation team knows who I am, and, I'm able to, you know, meet up and hang out with Monty's family, and they know who I am as well. But to be completely honest, if I was a nobody, I would still want for you guys to experience all this stuff that I'm experiencing. You know, I like, to be completely honest, like, I don't, you know what I mean? Like, I always feel, like, in my heart of hearts, like, no matter what I do, I want to take you guys with me, because not everybody is in the public eye. You know, not everybody is a murderer of birds or is a, you know, someone that's known in the community. You know what I mean? So I try to do the best I can when it comes to anything. You know, like I said, going to RTX, I know a lot of you guys helped me get there, and I know, honestly, without you guys, I wouldn't have been able to go. So I want it to be like, even if you didn't donate to help me go, I want you guys to be able to go along for the ride. And I want to do this, specifically this, when I go to RTX again, and it's because of you guys, you know? And I know a lot of you guys care about Ruby just as passionately and just as fiercely as myself and everybody else in that room and everyone else at Rooster Teeth and the community as a whole. And, I really care about you guys, and I really consider every single one of you guys. Like, if you watch Ruby, if you are a member of the Rooster Teeth community, we don't have to know each other by first name basis. We just have an instant bond. We have an instant connection. All of those people, I met them yesterday, and I love every single one of them with a, you know, with everything that I have in my being. And I genuinely want you guys to never forget that and never take away the fact that if I'm doing something, it's for my benefit. Everything that I do is honestly to and for the community. So I just want you guys to know about that. And I have two more things that I want to share with you guys. Two very important things that I honestly never thought in my entire life. They all just said, "We love you, Arnold." I hear you guys. But I have two more things that I want to share. And oh, hold on, let's go back over here really quick. Hey, what are you guys doing? Alrighty, so this is the last bit of the tour that's right here. And it's of Dead Fantasy. This is Monty Ohm's room, where he stayed, you know, during his days in Providence, Rhode Island with his brother and his family before he went to Texas. And, you know, let's just go in. This is Monty's room. It's incredibly overwhelming to be in here because this is the man that gave us so much. And we all miss him so much. And they did like this really nice tribute to him with flowers on the floor and on his bed. And I really wish that I got to meet him. I've told you guys this before, but I was someone who was very ashamed of myself for what I liked and what I cared about, and I always tried to conform with other people because, you know, I wanted to fit in and I wanted to, you know, have friends, and I wasn't truly myself until I found Ruby. You know, I liked anime, I liked video games, but I watched Ruby, and the thing that I can put into words is that it's home to me. It's the thing that I care about more than anything, and I really wish that I got to meet him to thank him and say thank you for everything that he's done for us. And it's so surreal to be in this room right now because I feel like he's here. You know, he has his Dead Fantasy posters up here. You know, he actually believed in what he was doing, you know, to the point where he made something and he was like, "I don't care what it is, I'm gonna do it and I'm gonna make it and it's gonna be great." You know, he had a vision, he had, you know, a passion for something, and he did it. And I'm so sad. I'm so sorry for his family. I'm sorry for Neith. I'm sorry
for Chivi and for the fans and for the people that he worked with and for Sheena and everybody, because, you know, I'm feeling this way and I was only inspired by his work. I was only inspired by the people that he inspired, and, you know, I knew Monty through his quotes, I knew Monty through his tweets, I knew Monty through his interviews, I knew Monty through Ruby, and I'm a fucking mess right now. And at the end of the day, I never thought in a million years that I'd be able to be here and to thank him for everything that he's done for us. And I really love the fact that they put the rose petals. You know, I kind of kept it together when I first walked in here, but I've been constantly coming back in this room throughout the last 2 days just because it's so surreal. It is so unbelievable how everything just looped around, you know. I discovered Ruby almost 4 years ago on Crunchyroll, thinking it was a video game, like an idiot. And I got into Ruby Volume 1, and as a result, I got into Rooster Teeth, I got into the podcast, I got into everything that Rooster Teeth does now, and I love everyone that works there and all of the shows that they work on and how hard they work on it because of him, because of Monty. And I really hope you guys appreciate the fact that, you know, we have each other and we have this community that we can all fall back in. Genuinely care about and genuinely say, like, we literally aren't a community, like, we're a family of people that just care about one another to the nth power, to the nth degree, and I'm very grateful for all of you guys for that. I'm a little bit more put together now, so, and we have, like, over here is, like, his sword set up, and a bit of his personal things. We have more, like, photoshopped work of his, photo manipulation by Monty Ohm here, original design by Tetsuya Nomura, and then we have like a gender bent, I think this is Squall from Final Fantasy VIII, if I'm not mistaken. You can see me in the picture right here, trying to get a better handle of myself. That's a lot of katanas, yeah, pretty much. He, like, kickstarted the whole, and, you know, it's also now that's a katana. But yeah, this is Monty's room, and I just want to say to everybody, thank you all for caring about me, and thank you guys all for being a part of my life, you know, after everything, you know, discovering my channel, my reactions, my reviews, all the Ruby content that I do, really relaying to me that I'm a light in some of your lives, which I honestly never thought in my life that I could ever really say that my videos are a gateway to people's happiness, and that's fucking insane, that's incredible, and I honestly have Monty to thank for every single step of the way into this YouTube career, into me kind of taking it, you know, taking a hold of a lot of the things that I do on the channel. So I have one more thing that I want to share and show with you guys, but I just want you guys to see the room one last time. I'm going to be coming by, you know, every now and then whenever we have these events together, and always coming in here to pay my respects, but thank you very much for everything, Monty. We all, you know, you are extremely missed and loved, and thank you for everything. So, with that all said, I hope you guys enjoyed that. I have one more thing to share with all of you, and then I'm going to wrap up because everyone has to get out and get going. So, and we have somebody knocking here too. Hi, Sammy.
Chivu has a question for you.
Yeah.
He'd like to know if you would like to introduce everyone to Monty.
Yeah, I told him I'm going to do that. is he, where is he?
Yes.
Right here.
Is he?
With the baby pictures.
Give me 1 second, guys. I have something special I want to share with you guys. Is it done?
Yeah.
You want me to go down with you?
Okay.
I got one more thing for you guys, and I can honestly say, like, I can't even put it into words, honestly, but I'm a little bit more put together now, but what's going on, I'm right here, sorry guys,
I have one more thing that I want to share, and this, at the end of the day, I understand, yeah, definitely, Dan, like, I honestly feel like no words can really reflect what I'm about to show and share for you guys. You mind closing the door? you mind standing right here?
Yeah.
Okay. The title of the video, well, I'm on my side right now, but the title of the video is Meeting Montiome. And the community has done so much for me, and the OMs have done so much in showing that support. And I honestly feel like I can't cry anymore, but thank you. I didn't even notice them over there, but I'd like for you guys to meet somebody. All right, you're on your end now.
Okay.
You want to say?
Hi, guys. As you know, Monty was passed, of course, and he was cremated, and his remains has been with our care. It was at Worth Up, my big brother's Woody's house, for a long time, and I said, maybe he should, you know, we can come, he can be over here where with his room and stuff and stuff. And I have with me in this contents right now is his remains, and I just wanted to show Monty, like, everything that his work has done. Like, say hi to all the fans that he's done. And right here, everybody, it's Monty. And I want to say that he thanks all of his fans and supporters for enjoying his work and for continuing to enjoy his work long after he's gone and all the things he did. And without you guys, none of this will happen. So Monty is here, and he expressed his greatest gratitude to everybody that who's watching this live stream right now. So Monty, love you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you guys so much.
Okay.
Thank you guys very much.
Bye, Arnold.
And I'm just gonna sit right here. That was the hardest part of yesterday was realizing that after everything I've done, after everything that has happened, I can say that I've met Monty and that I've been able to reflect what he's done for me, what he's done for all of us. Everybody here got to meet him at a previous event, and they kind of wanted to surprise me even more beyond just meeting Neith and Woody Ohm, like his other brothers, but meeting him. And I didn't understand what they meant at first, and then they brought the box out, and I didn't know how to respond, and I actually had to have like my own personal moment alone with him to really reflect and just thank him for everything that he's done. And like I said, I know a lot of people have never gotten to meet Monty. You know, a lot of you guys have never gotten to meet him or have never been to an RTX or something like that. And I just felt that, you know, sharing this with all of you guys, sharing the fact of even though he is gone, you know, he will always be in all of us. You know, he'll always be in our thoughts, in our memories, and, you know, in the videos that we make in response to him, and, you know, the reactions and things like that. I'm watching Red vs. Blue, and I know that he does a lot of work for seasons, I think, 9 and 10, or 8, 9, and 10. So, you know, his influence will still be affecting me long after, you know, even long after I've started Ruby. But I just really hope that a lot of you guys took something away from this, and I just really want you guys to know that everything that I do for the community, I always want you guys to be a part of it. I don't want you guys to feel like I'm this, you know, superstar or something like that. I personally don't think I'm much of an importance to anyone or anything. But I'm very much grateful for the fact that everybody here enjoys the videos that I do, and your support of me is through Monty. Without Monty, I honestly don't know where the hell I'd be, because without Monty, there'd be no, you know, Ruby, and without Ruby, I would have never gotten to Rooster Teeth, and then I wouldn't be doing the videos and the content that I'd be doing, and I'd probably be somewhere else, miserable, or living a lie like I had when I was in high school. But I just wanted to do this short stream because, you know, we're all getting ready to head out. I'm going to be going home soon. Everyone else here has to, like, either go to work or, you know, we're all going to be dispersing. Chibi's going to be going to work and everything. But I just wanted to make this live stream to tell all of you guys that I love you guys from the bottom of my heart. I love you guys more than most, you know what I mean? Like, and I have a very small circle of friends. I have a very small circle when it comes to my friends or my family. And I'm just thankful that I can meet people that just care about the same things I do and welcome me with open arms, you know. This has been a learning experience since I started it, you know, YouTube and streaming and all of that. And I'm just grateful that every time I turn my camera on and every time I start up a live stream, there's someone that's there waiting for me to either make them laugh or, you know, talk to them about stuff, whether it's discussions, reviews, reactions, theories, etc. You guys really help fill that void in my heart that I felt that was empty, because I always felt that it was something that was never going to be filled. Like, no matter what I did, I'd never be able to thank Monty. And I've mentioned that so many times, and it felt like a great, like a weight was lifted to know that I actually got to get out what I wanted to get out to him for the last time before, you know, his remains get sent over to where he was born. So, or, you know, where his family originated. I this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity that I'm incredibly fortunate and grateful to be able to have. And like I've mentioned, you guys' support of me and enjoying the content that I do, you know, and helping me become more of a prolific YouTuber and a streamer, and helping me, you know, become recognized in the community and support what I do, and Rooster Teeth supporting what I do and sharing that experience with other people in the community. It's unheard of. Like, it really is. It's something that I've even told people, you know, we had long discussions where I'm just reflecting. I'm just saying, like I couldn't have thought that my life would ever reach this point, because it's just, you guys were the ones that kind of dictated what my channel and what my content and what I was capable of. You guys honestly made me a better person, and being true to myself and not being ashamed of what I love and what I enjoy, you guys made me reflect and become a better content creator. You know, I don't just do reactions now. I do live stream discussions, I do reviews, I stream video games, I do news and information, and I honestly am proud of what I do now. And you guys help me out every step of the way. And, you know, no matter what, it's as cliche and, you know, as cliche and cheesy as it might be, without you guys, we are nobody, you know. And I never want you guys to forget that. So thank you guys very much for watching the stream. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope it wasn't too emotional for some of you. I know, like, I was trying to keep myself composed until I got in here and until I realized, like, you know, it's going to be a feels trip. But I hope you guys enjoyed. And one last time before I end the stream, thank you, Monty, for everything that you've helped all of us with in our lives, for bringing us joy, for bringing us passion, creativity. I can honestly say I never thought that I'd be here in my entire life. Even after you passed, I never thought I'd ever be able to thank you for everything that you've helped with me personally and the community. And with the 20 people that are here in this house, with the 450 people watching this stream, and for whoever ends up watching this afterwards, you have changed our lives forever, and we miss you incredibly, dearly, and no matter what, I will continue to cherish your legacy until the day I die. So thank you guys so much for watching, and that is everything that I wanted to relay and share with you guys. I'm going to be packing up, getting ready to go home. But I hope you guys enjoy this. This video will always be up on the channel for you guys to just come back and reflect and think on. But thank you guys very much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.